The end of this book ends with you saying, go forth and prosper.
Yes.
Okay, which sounds like the end of like a church service.
Uh-huh.
Go forth, you know, and prosper. Will this book make people rich? If they read this book, will they have a prosperous life?
Absolutely not. What you will have is a different attitude in your approach to becoming prosperous. That's what this book will do. This book will simply make you stay true to your dream. It will make you be determined to find the successful version of yourself. At the end of the day, I want people to be better. That's why I'm sharing this information. I don't want to be successful by myself. There's enough success in the world for everybody. Everybody should be able to get a piece. And I think that if everybody adapts that mindset, that our world will ultimately become a better place. Right now, it's a crab in a barrel mentality. And it takes people to speak up about being positive, about bringing people close together, and that's what I do. You know what? I think that I have a very interesting story. And here's the thing with me, I'm not selfish with information. I think in the entertainment business, people become selfish with information. Like, when they make it, people get to a high level of success and they don't share the story of their road to success.
Oh, because they feel it's competition.
Yeah, like, I don't want other people to come up and take my spot. Right. But that story can be useful to others with a dream, with goals, with aspirations, you know? Some people need to know how many times you heard the word no before that word yes came. Some people need to know how many times the door was slammed in your face, how many times rejection was literally at your doorstep and you felt like your dream was not going to become a reality.
Well, the book is like a motivational seminar.
It really is, man. I mean, it's me being 100% honest. I'm giving you the good, the bad, the ugly, whether it was negative, or one level of negative.
If somebody out there who's facing a lot of rejection or things are rough in their life, what's a negative? What's like a rough patch you went through that you pushed through anyway?
A rough patch? I say the roughest patch was in stand-up comedy. When I was a young comic coming up, I wanted to audition for the comic strip, which is in New York. There's a guy named Lucian who ran the comic strip. And this guy's opinion of comedy was the ultimate opinion. He saw Eddie Murphy and said, this is gonna be the next guy. He saw Seinfeld, said, this is gonna be the next guy. He has so many stars that came up underneath his wing where he put his hands on them by saying, you're gonna be a star, and it happened. So his word was like the word to get. I auditioned for the comic strip, and Lucian tells me to come back to his office. And he sits me down. To my face, he goes, I don't think this is for you. I don't think comedy is your thing. You should find a job, and you should look to do something else with your life, because this isn't it for you. No laughter afterwards. Blank stare. I'm waiting for the punchline. I'm like, all right, well, when's it get funny? Here's the funny. I'm not laughing. This seems real.
Yeah.
It seems like this is real.
You're right, right?
He said, thank you for coming, but unfortunately, you won't be performing here. That's it. And I had to get up and walk out the office. And that was like literally the first punch in the stomach that I took. And it took a friend of mine telling me, why do you care about somebody else's opinion? He told me, you're in charge of your own destiny. He said, you're in competition with yourself. The day that you give up on you is the day that you gave up on your dream. So if you're in the business of giving up on your dream, then I don't want to be in the business of being your friend. I think you're talented, so why don't you stay true to what you believe that you can do? And it was words like that that really made me get that skin, that thick skin, to deal with Hollywood and rejection. And when I heard no 1,000 times, it started to roll off my back. And when I got that one yes, I made the decision to never hear no again. So it's those stories that really would help that younger generation that's coming up in that business to say, you know what, I'm going to stay true to my dream because there is a light at the end of the tunnel. And I'm pure prime example of that light. I've been in the business 19, 20 years, man, and that last 5 to 6 has been successful. And I'm very happy now, but there was a road for me getting here. And that road and that story should be told. Hence my book, How Good of a Talker Am I?